Well, the market is now crowded with all sorts of online music services. One company that tries to make sure that artists do get paid is something called the SoundExchange. It collects money for performers and labels when songs are played on digital radio. SoundExchange has distributed more than $3 billion of royalties to labels and artists since 2003. The president and CEO, Michael Huppe, joins us now live from Washington. Great to have you on the show, Michael. First of all, just explain for our viewers exactly what you do. Presumably, is the business model that you don't have to, the likes of Pandora and so on and so forth, don't have to do this research themselves. They can pay you. You're a non-profit organization and you can do the research for them. Is that more or less the crux of your business model?
That's right, Nina. Thanks for having us here today. So SoundExchange, at a very high level, we are a non-profit here in Washington, and we collect digital radio royalties from over 2,500 digital radio services. We represent essentially every recording artist and record label in the industry. So the services pay us, and a significant portion of streaming revenue in the US goes through SoundExchange and is paid out to over 100,000 record label and artist accounts. So in a nutshell, we help enable much of the digital radio business here in the United States.
So in the midpoint of this fight between the likes of Taylor Swift and the big corporations, be it Apple, although Apple has mollified its stance and changed things, and Spotify, where do you stand? Do you think that she's got a point, or that her point is a little bit idealistic?
I think Taylor Swift has an excellent point. You know, she showed a lot of courage in speaking out, and more artists are speaking out on this issue. The fact of the matter is, when you have companies that are making billions of dollars off the creative work of the artists and the investment of the record labels, it's only fair that those companies share appropriately in the revenue stream with the artists and labels that really create the product that's the core of their business.
Of course, it takes somebody with the confidence of the huge numbers of records that she sold as Taylor Swift to make this kind of point. If an artist who was not as well known were to make this point, it would come across as though they're grumbling because they hadn't yet made it to the big time, right? So do we need more advocates like Taylor Swift to actually stand up and make the big corporations think?
Well, the more artists that speak out and you know, fight to make sure they're paid fairly, the better off we all are. And, you know, the thing about SoundExchange that's helpful is we represent all recording artists and all record labels. So when some of the biggest digital radio services in the United States stream their music, we represent everybody from Taylor Swift on down to the newest, youngest up-and-coming recording artist, everybody from the big record labels down to the small record labels. So one thing that SoundExchange is able to do is to sort of aggregate all of that force of the entire recorded industry and try to fight for the fair, long-term value of music.
Just run us through some of your facts and figures here. I'm looking here at you know, the fact that you've got tens of millions of lines of data that you report on a monthly basis. You've had $2 billion worth of revenues, as we were saying, distributed to artists to make sure they get their fair share. Why are you still non-profit? How important is that to your business model?
Well, that's a great question and one that we get. The reason we're a non-profit is because we were created by the entire recording industry to help administer this part of the music space. You know, our board is basically half record label, half artist. We represent the largest record labels to the smallest record labels. We represent the biggest artists to the smallest. And we also have on our board even representation from the unions, the non-featured performers and background singers and vocalists. So the reason we're nonprofit is we were created from the industry to do this. And the beauty of the fact that we are nonprofit is it allows us to do things that are in the best long-term interest of the industry. You know, we aren't beholden to hitting numbers this quarter or next quarter. We just do what's right for the whole industry.
When you look at something like Spotify, the reason why I mentioned this is that Spotify defends its freemium model because it democratizes access to music here. So do you totally disagree with the way how Spotify, its business model works? Because obviously if it's not giving back the revenues to artists, they feel hard done by. But again, it's saying it's democratizing music for the people who don't want to or can't pay for it.
Well, I won't speak specifically about Spotify, But in a general sense, at SoundExchange, we tend to be agnostic about business models. You know, the beauty of the digital space is that it allows for an immense number of different business models, different products that can be provided to consumers, different ways for people to get their music in different places like never before. So what we at SoundExchange, and really what I think everyone should be focused on, is focusing on making sure that the people that create the music, the artists, the labels that invest in it, that they're paid fairly whatever the business model is. So whether it's ad-supported, whether it's subscription, or whether it's some other business model that takes hold 5 years from now, the business model is less important than making sure that people get a fair market value for that input into the service.